guys, welcome back to my channel. Happy 2017. Happy late 2017. I know I still have my mini Christmas trees behind me, but I just don't want to take them down because I love Christmas, but mainly because me and Adriana put up those trees and they're just like really special to me. So I'm probably going to have them as my background for this video and also the next, and then the third video that will be going up, I'll probably take them down. But anyways, today I'm bringing you this makeup tutorial. This is basically, I don't know what to call this video really, because I feel like this is my signature makeup look. You can also say this is my everyday makeup look, but not as intense as this. Like, this is what I do whenever I do go to work, and then whenever I'm off, I might do the same technique, but with less of a smoky eye. Does that make sense? So I really don't know what to call this video. Anyways, I have been in love with this Tarte Men Eater palette. I got it for my birthday. I really love this palette. I love the packaging, but most importantly, I do love the product inside of it. I love the colors. I love the color selection. Like, I've used this palette so much ever since I got it. I've literally used it more, I'll tell you, more than my Tartlet and Bloom palette. I've used this one way more. So I can just take it with me in my makeup bag, and that's the only palette that I need. And maybe a black eyeshadow by Urban Decay. So in this tutorial, I showed you how to pair it with a nude lip, but I also like to wear it with a red lip sometimes. Let me try it on for you. So as you can tell, with the red lip, it just gives it a more classy kind of feel. I really hope you enjoy it. Let me know what you think on the comments below. And also, all of the products are going to be listed down below, if you're wondering. Also, don't forget to subscribe to my channel so you don't miss out any future videos. And I will also have the link to my Instagram down below. Okay, so the first thing I'm gonna do is just grab a makeup wipe and just run it all over my face to remove any dirt and oils that I produce throughout the day. Now for me, it's really important to moisturize because I do have drier skin. I do get really oily right there on my nose, but the rest of my face is really dry. I'm gonna start off by using my eye cream. This one is the Augenist Eye Renewal Eye Cream. I've been using this one because this is what I have from whenever I was working at Sephora. I did receive a lot of gratis, but I do want to look for a good cruelty-free eye cream. So if you know of one, let me know. Actually, Tarte makes one. I want to give that one a try. All right, so next is my moisturizer. Lately, I've been using this. This one is by Bliss. It's the Exclusion. I just use it because it's, again, what I have from my gratis. So I don't necessarily love this moisturizer. I like it, but again, this is what I have in my stash. I'm getting a pimple right there on my nose. How annoying is that? All right, and last but not least, I'm gonna use this Bite Lip Balm. I think it's actually a mask, but I love using it to hydrate my lips before I do my makeup. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and let the skincare products do their thing. I'm gonna start off with my eyeshadow primer, which is the MAC Soft Ochre Paint Pots. I'm trying to really finish this. I don't like it as much as I remember loving it. All right, next are my brows. I have been using the new NYX Eyebrow Pencil. This is the color Brunette, so I really like it because it's more of a powdery pencil. I'm really happy with this product because I finally found a drugstore brow pencil that does not look red on my brows. And you guys, this is literally my brow routine. Like, I do nothing else but just use this pencil on my brows. Ugh, I always feel like I look so weird right around this step. Okay, so now for eyeshadows, I have been using lately every single day. This is the Men Eater palette by Tarte. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and start by using Meow, which is a white color of the palette with a big shader brush. This is by Zoeva. It's a 220 Luxe shader brush. Whatever's left on the brush, I like to just bring it down to make the crease color blend a little bit easier. I'm gonna take a crease brush now, and sometimes I like to take Purr, which is a more pinky color. Right now I'm gonna take Saucy. So I use either one, sometimes I mix them. Depends how I feel like doing my makeup. So right now I'm gonna only use Saucy and apply it onto my crease. I'm gonna apply this color high enough so that way whenever I open my eye, you can still see the color. If you've been following me for a little bit now, you know that most of my eye makeup looks, I love to like just elongate the look. So this tutorial is no different. I'm gonna take that same color one more time, and I'm just gonna go ahead and create that cat eye effect. All right, now I'm gonna pick up a smaller crease brush to get a very precise area, which is the outer corner. You can totally use the one before. I have done that. This one's just a little bit more precise. I think I'm gonna use Midnight on the outer part of my lid. Did I say lid? The outer part of my crease, the outer V. So right here. Alright, so now I'm going to take a flat shader brush. This one is by Zoeva. This is a 234 brush, and I'm going to take Foxy, one of my favorite colors. Actually, all of them are my favorite colors. And I really like to pack on the product onto my brush, so I wiggle it, and then I'm going to press, really sticking it onto the eyelid. Okay, next I'm going to take a eyeliner. This one is the Too Faced Perfect Eyes Waterproof Eyeliner. I actually really like this eyeliner, but I'm gonna use it on the outer part of the eye, and I'm literally just gonna focus it on that outer part. I'm gonna take that little sponge that comes on the back of the pencil and blend it out. Okay, so the next thing I'm gonna do is pick up a small pencil brush. This one is my favorite one. It's by Louise Young. This is the LY13. I'm gonna take some of the Urban Decay Blackout eyeshadow. This is my favorite black in the world. It's the best. Okay, so now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pick up another pencil brush. I'm gonna take some of this really beautiful pearly white color right here. I'm going to apply this color right on the center of the eyelid. It creates a lot more dimension. It creates more of a wet type of look to the eye. Okay, and I'm going to go ahead and curl my lashes. And the mascara that I've been using lately is this Essence Lash Princess mascara. I actually bought so many products from this brand right here. I have tried a couple of them and I really, really like them. So I'll be doing a haul and also a tutorial. So that's one coat. And then what I like to do, I took this from an Ulta. This was like a little sample for their Clinique, I don't know what it's called, the high impact mascara. And I like to use this little comb to comb my lashes. All right, so I'm gonna take a makeup wipe and just wipe away any fallout. Just be really careful whenever you wipe the outer part of the eyeshadow, unless you want really sharp look. I personally don't want it to be sharp, so what I'm gonna do is on this pat, once I get closer to the shadow, take my pinky and just mess it up a little bit. All right, so I'm gonna come back to the eyes in a little bit. I'm gonna do my complexion now. And lately, the foundation that I've been using is actually not a foundation. It's the Tarte BB Cream. Actually, it's not a BB cream either. It's a BB Tinted Treatment 12-Hour Primer. So basically what this is, it's sort of like a BB cream. It's a lot more lightweight because it's more of a moussey consistency. I literally forget, whenever I have this on, I forget that I have makeup on my face. That's how lightweight this is. This is not gonna give you a full coverage, but it is gonna give you enough for every day. At least for me, it's enough because I have redness that I wanna cover, but I don't wanna necessarily cover my skin. I still want my skin to show through the makeup. And what I like to do, sometimes I use my fingers, but I recently purchased a new brush on my birthday. My birthday was December 27th, just in case you're wondering. This is the It's Cosmetics. I don't know, I don't think it has a name, but it looks like this, and it's really soft. It's actually for powder, but I love using it for my foundation. And another cool thing about this product is that it dries completely matte, so if you don't want to, you don't have to set it. You definitely can. Most of the time I just skip that step. So I usually use either the Tarte Shape Tape, which is amazing, and then this is the Tarte Smooth Operator Concealer in the shade Light, and then this one is Light Medium. I have seen tutorials on people using the Shape Tape and they just wipe it underneath their eye. I can't do that. I did try it. It's way too much. Like, this is enough. Let me show you how much it covers. So I focus it right where I have most of the darkness. I blend it down. Blend it out. Can you tell how much that little dot covered compared to this side? A lot. So like I said, I typically don't powder my face because I don't feel the need to, since all of the products that I use dry pretty matte. But like for work, where I know I'm gonna be there for a longer period of time and I want my makeup to look fresh for a longer period of time, I use the Laura Mercier Translucent Powder. It's really good. Right now, I'm not gonna powder though. So I'm gonna skip to bronzer. I stopped contouring every day because I feel like with a more dramatic look like this, I don't want everything on my face to be really structured. I like I said, a little bit of imperfection. Well, I'm gonna use my bronzer as blush. It's still gonna define my face and give me a little bit of color. I'm now gonna take a brown eyeliner, pencil eyeliner, and run it underneath my lower lashes. And you can take your pinky and just quickly smudge it a little bit so it's not so perfect. All right, and now I'm gonna take another flat shader brush, or any small brush, really. This is a MAC, oh no, no, no. This is another Zoeva brush. And I'm gonna take the darkest brown in the palette on the very tip and just press it underneath that liner. And you also wanna make sure that the lower lash line connects to the top of the rest of the smoky eye. Usually I don't wear fake eyelashes, not anymore. Now, I actually prefer not wearing eyelashes. But since this is a tutorial, I'm gonna make it a little bit more glamorous. I'm gonna wear fake lashes. And if I do wear fake eyelashes, I don't wear my super dramatic lashes anymore. For some reason, I feel like my whole makeup style really changed. Now I go for more of a natural lash look. The lash glue that I've been using is a Tarte Pro. It only comes in black, which is really nice because that way I don't have to hide the lash band. But that also means that you have to be very careful when you place it because wherever you touch, it's going to dry black. Okay, so these lashes already had a little bit of mascara from the previous time that I wore them. I know, kind of gross. So I'm not gonna apply too much mascara, but I am gonna do a fresh coat. It's a very light coat to make them dark. And I'm also gonna do a little bit underneath my eyes. All right, so we're almost done. I almost forgot one very, very important step. I'm gonna apply my inner corner highlight using this Essence 2-in-1 eyeshadow and liner in the color 02 Peach Perfect. This is the most beautiful-est inner corner highlight you'll ever have in your life. Apply this on the inner corner. Pretty heavily, actually. I really want it to show. So I apply it right there, and then I also bring it towards the inner corner of the lower lash line, and then I take my pinky, and I just bring it over a little bit, so it blends with the darker shadow underneath. So see how it just makes your eyes pop a lot more? All right, so after that, I'm gonna take a smaller brush. You can leave it like that, but I want it to blend a little bit more with the lip color. So I'm going to take Foxy one more time, and we're going to apply that over our highlight. You really don't have to do this step if you don't want to. It doesn't really change the color that much, but I feel like it just sets it in place so it stays there for a longer period of time. All right, so the look is pretty much done. All I have to do is throw in a lip, and I feel like with this makeup, You can really tone it down with your lips, which is usually what I do. I usually do a nude. Or you can really play up your lips. It's still gonna look beautiful. You can throw in a red. I do that sometimes too. But the combo that I've been using is this Lorac Visionary Lipstick. Their lipsticks are the best. They're the best. So that's how this lipstick looks like. I like it on its own too, but I prefer to apply a gloss on top of it. And the one that I've been using is also by Lorac. This one is called Socialite. So that's the lip combo that I've been wearing with this look. Sometimes I do want a red, like I said. So I do the Milani Matte Confidence lipstick, which is really pretty red. Alright guys, so that's all for this tutorial. Please don't forget to like this video if you did like the tutorial. Also, don't forget to share and comment down below. Tell me what your thoughts were. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel so you don't miss out any future videos that I will be uploading. Also, don't forget that you can follow me on Instagram. I will have my username for Instagram on the description bar below. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you on my next video.